Hello, I'm Robin Whalley and today we're going to do some pixel peeping. I want to return to testing a few RAW converters using a Fuji RAW file. I've done this in the past looking at RAW converters and the performance, but I've used other converters. Today I'm going to be using a few converters that I seem to get quite regular requests for from people who watch the other video. First, there's Iridient X-Transformer. Then we've got Affinity Photo using the develop persona, and also Capture One version 12, where I'm going to be using the free Fuji Express version of the software. Now the approach I'm going to take is to develop the same two RAW files in each of the applications. We'll then put each of the conversions into the same image in Photoshop as separate layers. This means we can turn the layers on and off to judge the difference between them. What I primarily want to judge is the quality of the detail and sharpness produced in the images. I'm actually less bothered about the exposure and colour unless there's obvious problems in there. What I'm keen to find out is to check for what I call the wiggly worm pattern, and that's plagued me in the past when I've used Lightroom, and you'll see that very shortly. Now, because all the converters are different in operation, I've adjusted the settings in each to try to achieve an optimal balance of detail, sharpness and image quality. What you can't do is just take the same settings from one and apply them to another. They don't work optimally when you do that. Now, the two images I've selected for this are ones that I shot in Scotland last week. The first one you see on screen at the moment is a forest scene, and the other is actually a mountain snow scene. The forest scene is what I think's going to be the most demanding for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I shot it using the Fuji 18-135 lens at the wide end of the focal range. Now this lens isn't as good as others at resolving fine detail at the wide end. The other reason for this scene being quite demanding is that it features grass, moss, ferns and pine trees. Now these are all subjects that seem to cause the wiggly worm effect, especially when they're shot using the 18-135 lens. At the moment, I'm in Lightroom, and if we zoom into the foreground detail of this image at 200% magnification, you'll see that it looks a little false. It's almost as if it's a cartoon. Now that's the wiggly worm effect, where all the edges appear to be quite wiggly. If we look into the branches of the pine tree, you'll also see it. Now the other scene that we've got was captured using a Fuji 10-24mm lens. And this lens doesn't seem to suffer as much from the wiggly worm effect as the other, and it seems to be able to resolve much more detail. If you look at the foreground detail that we've got here, it's actually looking pretty impressive in Lightroom. But if you move a little bit further out, you can see that the detail is less clear. Obviously, it's going to be difficult for this lens to resolve fine detail at this distance, but rendering of the image by Lightroom isn't helping here. Now, the first of the RAW converters I want to test is the Iridient X-Transformer, and it's actually quite different from the rest of the converters. I have the software installed as a plugin for Lightroom, and if I launch the settings screen, you'll see why I say it's different. What you don't see in this is any of the normal adjustment controls you'll find in other RAW converters, because it doesn't work that way. The software is intended to do a conversion from a RAW file, and so what you see are some of these settings here where you talk about the RAW process and the sharpening. What the software does is simply convert the Fuji RAW file into the DNG format. You'll see what I mean if I run it against one of the files. All that X-Transformer's doing is taking care of the demosaic of the RAW file and turning it into something that then Lightroom can read. And it's this demosaic that seems to be part of the problem that causes the wiggly worm effect. The other thing X-Transformer does is apply the excellent Iridient sharpening. After this, you've got a DNG file in Lightroom that you can edit using Lightroom adjustments. What I'm going to do is copy the development settings from the version of the RAW file I processed earlier using Lightroom. What I don't need though is the sharpening and noise reduction, because that's what XTransform has already applied in the conversion. So what you see there is a version of the Iridient file with the same development settings as the Lightroom version, except for sharpening and noise reduction. And if you compare the two, they look pretty similar. Now, after the last video I did comparing Fuji RAW file conversions, quite a few people asked me to check the XTransformer performance. I'm also keen to test it, as XTransformer is what I currently use for processing my Fuji RAW files. The other two RAW converters in the test are very similar to Lightroom in that they offer a range of adjustment tools. What I've done is processed the RAW files independently, concentrating on the contrast, exposure, shadows, sharpening and noise reduction. And I've now got the results from each of the conversions in a Photoshop file where each is on a separate layer so we can make comparisons. Let's start by looking at the Lightroom version zoomed to 200% magnification. Now, it still doesn't look quite right in the problem areas, but it looks slightly better than I was expecting given what I saw in Lightroom. Now, it's quite possible that Lightroom Preview is causing part of the problem, and once the image is processed into a TIFF file, the results are improving. If I zoom the image out to 100%, it still looks good, but it has a slightly unnatural feel to it. Let's now look at the XTransformer conversion at 200%. Now personally, I feel these results are better and have better detail. It just appears more natural. Let's have a look at the branches of the trees now at 300%. So this is 200% with the XTransformer, and that's the Lightroom version now at 200%. I'll zoom in again, and you can start to see in the Lightroom version that the fine detail is quite wiggly. The XTransformer version actually appears a little bit softer, but it's more natural. There's Lightroom, there's XTransformer. Softer, but more detailed. To me, the Lightroom version appears to have overly emphasized the fine details, but that's causing this unnatural effect. Let's now compare the Affinity Photo version with Lightroom. At 200%, Affinity appears a little less sharp, but more natural in the foreground grasses. If we look at the trees, it's definitely more natural. But again, it's not as sharp. What you may also be able to see when I turn off the Affinity layer is that the image is shifting slightly. Now, it appears that the lens correction module in Affinity is stretching the image out from the center. You'll see what I mean if I position this now on the center and turn off the Affinity layer. Let's compare now the Affinity version with XTransformer. So comparing Affinity with X-Transformer, X-Transformer appears to have slightly more fine detail and is a little bit sharper, but actually it's quite marginal. Let's now look at Capture 1. Comparing Capture 1 to Lightroom, the results appear very good and especially very natural in the grasses. It also appears very natural in the trees as well, and there's plenty of detail in there. Now if I compare Capture 1 to X-Transformer, I think what I'm seeing here is that X-Transformer has the edge, but it's only very slight. If you look at the bark of the pine trees, Capture 1 appears to have more of a blockier appearance. So that's X-Transformer, and just watch the pine tree bark here. And that's Capture 1, and it just feels a little bit more blocky and not quite as much fine detail in there. Let's now have a look at the second image that I've processed in the same way as the first. Now remember, this uses a better lens than in the first example. The image was captured on the 10-24 Fuji lens, and I've shot it at around 12mm focal length. I've also used an aperture of f11 so that diffraction won't be an issue, and it's also going to give us enough depth of field to ensure the image is sharp front to back. Let's start by looking at the foreground of the Lightroom version. Now the results seem quite good, but the fine detail in the grass and heather hasn't really separated out very well. If I switch on the Iridient X-Transformer layer, you'll see this immediately. So we now have lots of separation and fine detail in these grasses and heathers. It's even more obvious if you look a little bit further out towards the centre of the image. And looking at the mountains, there appears to be more and sharper fine details in the X-Transformer conversion. So that's the Lightroom version, and that's the X-Transformer. Let's compare the Affinity conversion. So that's Affinity, and that's X-Transformer. X-Transformer appears much sharper and more detailed. Let's compare it back to Lightroom. So that's Lightroom, and that's Affinity. Lightroom, Affinity. So Affinity appears better than Lightroom in these areas, but it doesn't appear as good as X-Transformer. Let's have a look at the midground. So that's Lightroom, and that's Affinity. Slightly better than Lightroom, but there's not too much in it. Compare it now to X-Transformer, and X-Transformer's better. And in the mountains again, X-Transformer appears sharper than Affinity, and Lightroom appears slightly sharper than Affinity as well in that area. Let's now compare Capture 1. So we have Lightroom there, and we've got the Capture One version. And immediately we can see that the Capture One version is much sharper than the other. Let's compare it to X-Transformer. And whilst the image detail of Capture One again is just a little bit blockier, actually it looks sharper than the X-Transformer version. Now this might be because, having seen the previous result that I processed, I actually pushed the sharpening a little bit more with a smaller radius using Capture One. The midground, if we look at that, well, Capture One's very impressive there, and it appears better than the Iridient. And on the mountains, it's slightly sharper and a little bit more detailed than the Iridient, although I would say if you watch the rocks here as I turn on Capture One, it appears a little bit more contrasty and blocky, but if you can control that, you should be getting a really good result. Comparing it to Lightroom, you can see that Capture One's definitely clearer and sharper in the mountains. So, what's my conclusion? Well, the first thing is, I don't like the RAW conversion from Lightroom still. I'm not overly impressed by the way the sharpening and noise reduction affects the Fuji files. If I look at X-Transformer, I think it gave excellent performance with both of these images, and that's even with relatively modest settings that haven't been fine-tuned for the image. The other thing about X-Transformer is that it allows me to work with Lightroom tools, which for me is important for reasons I'm not going to go into in this video because it will take too long. Affinity, well, it puts in a very credible performance. It produces very natural results, which I think is absolutely wonderful. It wasn't the sharpest and most detailed in the image. What I am concerned about, though, is this stretching effect it had on the image, and all the images I converted appeared to have an extra 30 pixels on the width and around 20 pixels on the height. And finally, we have Capture One 12, which probably surprised me the most when I used it with the better lens. In the first image, I thought the conversion was a little blocky and the X-Transformer was better. But in the second image, the results are absolutely superb. If I wanted to produce a fine art print from a RAW file like this, I'd start with Capture One RAW conversion. And I can't believe that this software is actually free for Fuji users. What you should also keep in mind from this is, though, we've been pixel peeping at 200% magnification. In the real world, all the conversions were amazingly detailed, sharp, and would all produce excellent prints. What you would probably find, though, is that some of the prints just appear that little bit more natural and possibly have qualities that are difficult to put your finger on. So at the end of the day, whatever converter you're going to use for the Fuji RAW files, it's one you need to feel happy with and that you can produce good results. I'm hoping these have given you some other ideas of converters that may be worth trying. Certainly, Capture One is brilliant for a RAW converter that's free. Iridient X-Transformer, if you find you need to work in Lightroom, that would also give great results. And if you've left Adobe products behind completely and switched to Affinity, then Affinity does give really good results as well. I hope you've enjoyed this. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.